everyone. In this video, we will cover the current affairs. Before we move ahead, let me inform you that these questions are part of our daily 20 MCQ series in GK Today's Academy Android application. So if you are looking for the text version of these questions and their explanations along with the interactive quiz, you may consider joining our daily 20 MCQ series in Academy Android application. So in this app course, you get daily 20 MCQs, a fortnightly quiz, a monthly revision document, and also category-wise revision ebooks, which are optimized for reading on your mobile itself. Apart from it, you are also able to access all archives of questions from January 2020 onwards. Please check our Telegram channel. The link is given in the description box. You can subscribe to it if you find it relevant. For hard copy books, you can visit our website gktbooks.com. Okay, so now without wasting any further time, let's get started. Good morning, everyone. Welcome back to GK Today. And today we'll be discussing most important MCQs for 11th of November 2021. Starting with very first question, Ministry of Information and Broadcasting has created single window filming mechanism along with which ministry? So an integrated single window filming mechanism has been created by Ministry of Railways and Ministry of Information and Broadcasting. And the objective of the scheme is to make the permission for filming across railways premises easier and more efficient. And under the mechanism, filmmakers can submit online applications for filming at various railway locations under jurisdiction of any zonal railways in a centralized way. Now, apart from it, Prime Minister Narendra Modi has launched Pradhan Mantri Atmanirbhar Swasth Bharat Yojana in Varanasi. And the scheme aims to strengthen healthcare infrastructure across the country to fill critical gaps in public health infrastructure, especially in critical care facilities and primary care in both rural and urban areas. So this aim of Yojana is to build an IT-enabled disease surveillance system at block, district, regional and national levels. Now apart from it, Union Ministry of New and Renewable Energy has launched a new market segment named as Green Day Ahead Market, and it will enable electricity generation and distribution companies to buy or sell renewable energy through open access. So now with this, the government is aiming to gradually shift from long-term power purchase agreement, that is PPA based contracts, to the market-based models. Okay. Question number 2. In the COP26 climate summit's first major deal, the leaders promised to end and reverse deforestation by which year? So in the COP26 climate summit's first major deal, as many as 110 world leaders promised to end and reverse deforestation by the year 2030. So this pledge, which was named as Glasgow Leaders Declaration on Forest and Land Use, includes $12 billion in public funds and $7.2 billion of private investment of public and private funds. Also, a previous deal of 2014 had failed to slow deforestation at all. Now, in the previous lecture, we have seen that Prime Minister of India, Narendra Modi, had launched IRIS, that is Initiative for the Resilient Island States, for developing infrastructure of small island nations. Also, Prime Minister said that the small developing states, or SIDs, face the biggest threat for climate change, and India's space agency ISRO, that is Indian Space Research Organization, will also build a special data window for them to provide information about cyclones, floods, earthquakes, coral reef monitoring and coastal line monitoring, etc., with the help of satellites. Now apart from it, Narendra Modi and Boris Johnson from UK have jointly launched a new flagship international initiative at the COP26 World Leaders Summit named as Green Grids Initiative, One Sun, One World and One Grid. So this is aimed at accelerating the development of interconnected electricity grids across
continents, countries and communities. Also, it aims to improve energy access of the poor through mini grids and off-grid solutions. Also, a glacier in Antarctica has been formally named as Glasgow Glacier in honor of the city that is hosting the UN Climate Summit to mark the COP26. Okay. Question number 3. Mandakini River, which was seen in the news recently, starts in which state? So, River Mandakini, which is a tributary of Yamuna River, starts in Madhya Pradesh, Satna district and flows into the Yamuna in Uttar Pradesh, Chitrakoot district. So, this river flows through Sati Ansuya, which is a perennial trough where many springs feed into it, and it was seen in the news recently because encroachment, concretization and pollution are causing severe damages to the river. Okay. Now apart from it, Marusudar River is the largest tributary of River Chenab, and this river originates from Nunkun Glacier in Jammu and Kashmir. So a 1000 megawatt Pakal Dul hydroelectric project is being constructed across the Marusudar River by Chenab Valley Power Projects Private Limited. So recently the Union Power Minister R.K. Singh has virtually inaugurated the diversion of Marusudar River, which permits quicker construction of power project. Now apart from it, earlier we have seen that the government of Madhya Pradesh has announced to provide residential lands free of cost to the people of the state who do not own any land. And the land can be used for building own houses by the people, and these free plots would be provided under the scheme named as Mukhyamantri Avasi Bhu Adhikar Yojana. Also, Madhya Pradesh has decided to implement Mukhyamantri Rashan Aapke Dwar Yojana, and this will be implemented to benefit the poor tribal families. So it will be implemented in tribal development blocks of the state, excluding those blocks which fall under the district that are undergoing bipoles. And the scheme is going to benefit tribal families of around 7,511 villages in 74 development blocks of total 16 districts. Question number 4. Which country is set to provide India Green Guarantee to the World Bank to finance green projects? So UK will provide an India Green Guarantee to the World Bank to unlock £750 million for green projects across India. So this was announced at COP26 summit in Glasgow, and the Green Guarantee financing will support clean and resilient infrastructure in sectors including clean energy, transport and urban development. So UK committed over £210 million at the UN Climate Summit under PIDG, that is Private Infrastructure Development Group. Okay. Now in the previous lectures we have seen that recently India and UK have agreed upon a forward action plan on power, transportation, renewable energy, green finance and research as a part of 2030 roadmap. Also, a new climate finance leadership initiative India partnership has been signed with UK, and this has been agreed to mobilize the private capital into sustainable infrastructure in India. Okay. Question number 5. Which state launched Jan Sevak online portal and Jan Spandana, an integrated public grievance redressal system? So this has been launched by Karnataka, and Jan Sevak is an initiative to help people avail government services easily, and people can get up to 56 government services delivered to their doorsteps, including home delivery of ration, Aadhaar card, income certificate, etc., using a mobile application or website or via a call center. Now, a few days back, we have seen that Karnataka government has issued a circular imposing a ban on holding press conference and issuing statement by the bureaucrats. Also, Karnataka has decided to ban online gambling or betting and to amend the Karnataka Police Act of 1963. Now last month also we have seen that Government of Karnataka has decided to reintroduce industrial adalats, and this is aimed to resolve industry related problems on the spot and serve as a platform to get long lending lease. So earlier it has such system of industrial courts between the years 2008 and 2013. Also Union Defence Minister Rajnath Singh and Union Highways Minister Nitin Gadkari inaugurated the emergency landing facility on a national highway in the state of Rajasthan. So this is the very first time a national highway will be used for emergency landing of Indian Air Force aircraft. Okay. Question number 6. Which country is currently excavating the ancient kingdoms of Dadan and Lian? So archaeologists in Saudi Arabia are carrying out excavations of the ancient kingdoms of Dadan and Lian across 5 sites. And the kingdoms were important regional powers that flourished 2000 years ago. And the project is a Saudi-French partnership which aims to learn about their worship rituals, social life, and about their economy. So this excavation is expected to provide more details of these particular civilizations. Now apart from it, Saudi Arabia has launched National Infrastructure Fund to support up to 200 billion riyals in projects over the next decade. And it will be advised by the world's largest fund manager, BlackRock. So this fund will basically be invested in sectors such as water, transportation, energy, and health. Also in the previous lectures, we have seen that Saudi Arabia has recently announced that it aims to reach net zero greenhouse gas emissions by 2060. And it is the 10th largest emitter of carbon dioxide globally. Also, it is the largest emitter on a per capita basis among G20 countries. And not only this, recently Australia has given in principle to a target of zero net carbon emissions by the year 2050. Now apart from it, UAE has organized the annual meeting of the Board of Governors of Asian Infrastructure Investment Bank on the theme Investing Today and Transforming Tomorrow. Fine. Question number 7. What is the theme of National Ayurveda Day 2021? So this day is celebrated on the occasion of Dhanteras since 2016, and this year the theme was Ayurveda for Poshan. So Union Minister of Ayush, Mr. Sarbanand Sonowal, announced a corpus 260 crore rupees for expanding the infrastructure of National Institute of Ayurveda's satellite center that lies at Panchkula in Himachal Pradesh. Now apart from it, Kerala, Karnataka, Madhya Pradesh, Haryana, Chhattisgarh and Andhra Pradesh celebrate their statehood or foundation days on 1st of November. And in Kerala, the foundation day is celebrated as Kerala Piravi Day, while in Karnataka, the foundation day is celebrated as Karnataka Rajya Utsav. Now in the previous lecture we have seen that World Cities Day is observed annually on 31st of October every year to promote international communities' interest in global urbanization. And this year theme was Adapting Cities for Climate Resilience. Now apart from it, United Nations Disarmament Week is observed annually during the month of October. And it aims to promote the awareness and understanding the issues of disarmament in several countries. Okay. Question number 8. What is the classification of Ganga River dolphins as per IUCN? So these dolphins are the National Aquatic Animal of India and is listed as endangered under IUCN Red List. So the Union Jal Shakti Ministry has released a guide aimed at the safe rescue of stranded dolphins in India, and the guide has been developed by Turtle Survival Alliance and Environment, Forest and Climate Change Department of the Government of UP. Now earlier we have seen that the state of Punjab is set to commence the census of Indus River dolphins. Actually, in the year 2019, Indus River dolphin was declared as state aquatic animal of Punjab. Okay? Now, apart from it, tribes such as Khasis, Jaintias and Garos are the predominant tribal population of Meghalaya and comprises nearly half of Meghalaya's total population. And they practice a matrilineal system of inheritance where the youngest daughter in the family becomes the custodian of family's property. And why it is in news? Because recently the Khasi Hills Autonomous District Council has proposed a bill which aims for equitable distribution of parental property among the siblings. Okay? Now apart from it, Indian government and World Bank have signed a $40 million project to improve the quality of healthcare services in Meghalaya, named as Meghalaya Health System Strengthening Project. Okay? Question number 9. What is the upper threshold loan size for the Uniform Staff Accountability Framework for NPA accounts issued by the Government of India? So the Government of India has issued a Uniform Staff Accountability Framework for NPA accounts for loan limits up to 50 crore rupees. And the said guidelines would be implemented uniformly across all banks from 1st of April 2022. So these guidelines are aimed to make credit decisions faster and help support the economy. Also, at the same time, remove the apprehension that bankers could be punished for their bona fide commercial decisions going wrong. Okay. Now, apart from it, a 20-member empowered group of secretaries has been constituted by the Government of India to monitor the development and implementation of Pradhan Mantri Gati Shakti Master Plan. And the group would be headed by the Cabinet Secretary, and its members would include Chairman of Railway Board, Secretaries of Department of Road, Ports, Civil Aviation, Petroleum, Telecommunication, etc. Okay? Coming to last question, the Panchamrita concoction is associated with what? So this is a 5-fold strategy proposed by the Prime Minister of India at COP26 at Glasgow, and the strategy would help the world achieve the sustainable development goals by 2030. So basically it includes 500 gigawatt non-fossil energy capacity by 2030, then 50% renewable energy capacity by 2030, then reduce carbon emissions by 1 billion tons by 2030, also reduce the carbon intensity by 45% by the year 2030 and achieve net zero by 2030. Okay? So this is related to climate change. Now apart from it, the Union Minister of Youth Affairs and Sports has announced the National Sports Award 2021 recently, and 12 sports person have been announced for Majan Dhyanchand Khel Ratna Award 2021, which is awarded to the spectacular and most outstanding performance in sports over a period of previous 4 years. Also, Government of Telangana has been invited by FAO to participate in a virtual conference of the Food and Agricultural Organization, and the conference is being organized at Rome, Italy. So the state has been invited to deliver an address on quality seed production system, a success story of India, as Telangana is a seed hub. Fine. Now let's start with today's quiz. Here on the slide you can see 5 questions which have been taken from the past 2-3 days current affairs. Pause the video and try to solve each of these questions, and at the end of the lecture do not forget to share your scores in the comment section. So please be honest and do not cheat with yourself. So that's it for today. I hope you have liked the session. These were the important news and events from today, and we will meet again tomorrow with some more important current affairs. Till then, stay tuned. Thank you so much for watching, and please do not forget to subscribe to GK Today. With this, Meenu Sarthana signing off.